Okay. Yikes. Oh my gosh, big hair. Hello. Good morning, good morning. Excuse the cough again. It's going to go away, I'm sure of it. Good morning, good morning. You have a very hot, hello Kelly, good morning. Very hot cup of coffee. Hi Grace. Grace, I think I let a lot of people, hello, my goodness, hello Kristen. Grace, I think I approved a bunch of people that you had sent to the group, but I can't approve somebody with a man's name. Hi Jan, hi Tammy. So typically sometimes husband and wives have like one account, but I'm uncomfortable with if it is indeed a male, obviously having a male in the group, or if it's the wife, but the man's name. Hi Teresa, I just want the ladies to feel safe here. So maybe you can message me after the video and let me know what's the deal with that. Otherwise, I'm more than happy to have anybody invite their friends if they think they would be interested in what we do here on She Looketh Well. So I hope that's clear. So if it's a man or a man's name, I typically don't approve it. So, and I typically only approve people who either are friends or are good friends of friends. So I like to keep this a safe place for people that want to open up. So I'm excited, ladies. I am going on very little sleep, but I am so, so excited. I have no idea why, other than I just absolutely love this time of year. Yesterday we had our one word party with our family, and I just keep playing that over in my head and just how beautiful it is and was and is going to be. Hi Angela. it's so much better than any time of the year for me this time of year. Just the dedicated time to the Lord. The looking back and being so thankful and seeing his hand everywhere. I was just listening to King of My Heart by Stephanie, and I remember months ago crying and screaming that song out by faith, prophesying that song over our circumstances and our situations. Welcome, Denise, that he is good. You are good. You are good. You are good. And Stephanie has said before, you know, sometimes we sing because we believe it, and sometimes we sing until we believe it. And in the beginning of the year, that's what that song was to me. I was singing it until I believed it, and now to be singing it this morning just because I know that he's good. So seeing his hand and then excited that just the crazy cool things that are happening, even the last several days, I have such hope and am so excited to see what he has for this year. Not only for myself, but even then extending out to my family and what they shared and the words that they have for this year. And then you ladies, I get so excited reading all of your words that you share on New Year's Day. So be looking for that post. I'm going to have it scheduled to go up like at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. That's where you want to put your post, your word, and feel free to share. The more you share, the more people get out of it. So you can just share your word. Hello, Anne. Hello, beautiful woman. You can just share your word. Like I said, I kind of make my kids have a scripture to go with it that I can pray for them. You can share a scripture or scriptures. And even why it came to you and how it speaks to you and how you plan to hopefully see it manifest. I know Susan, who comes on here, she always shares so much good stuff of what she gets with her word. So really feel free to share whatever. Everybody is so encouraged by it. And it just kind of gets their hunger stirring too. So feel free to share whatever, as much or as little. I will share a lot. I have it already typed up and written out everywhere just because I've been meditating on it. So, hello Cindy. So I'll be sharing that tomorrow. And maybe we'll do a video tomorrow too. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just busting. I am just busting a gut here. I'm telling you, last night, just a cool little thing before I get into, I think I'm going to rename this day too. But anyway, I just had this incredible time with the Lord, and I said, I don't even think I spoke it. I think I thought it, that I was in Song of Solomon 2, which he has used for the last 2 years to speak to me. And it was just this beautiful time in his presence and hearing his voice. And I thought, well, if you woke me up at 2 something, I'm sure I would know it was you then. And at 2 o'clock, okay, it was 2:13. Well, I was laying in bed. I'm like, oh, do I want to get up? Should I just go to the bathroom or should I go back to sleep? And so I looked over at the clock and it was 2:13, and it's the verse in Song of Solomon that I love that says, "Arise, my darling, come away with me." And I'm just like, oh, I'm so yours. I'm yours, Lord. So got the light on and my journal and my Bible and spent an hour and a half with him in the morning at 2:13. It was just so beautiful. So He's calling, ladies, and that's what I want to talk about a little bit today. This is supposed to be a reframe, and I told you I just wanted some RE words. Well, now I can't remember. Oh, no, I remember what the word is. I want to call it respond instead of reframe, okay? I just feel like the last 24 hours he's just been speaking to me to respond. And I kind of feel like, okay, should I take a breath? Do you guys have anything to say before I keep on rambling? Because I'll just keep going. So if you have a comment, you want to pipe in, feel free to do that before I go off on respond / reframe, and I'll take a drink of coffee. Okay, I'm going to go on. I kind of feel like there's two camps of people, and I have found myself in both of these camps. So one, I feel like those are, that they're not even aware, that of their need. They're not even aware of the hunger and thirst in them, that what they're actually hungering and thirsting for is God. Okay. Hi, Leanne. They may not even be aware that he desires to be in fellowship with them, that he desires intimacy with them, oneness with him. You know, Jesus talked about him and the Father were one, and we are one with him. So that oneness, like, they're not even aware. They're not aware that they're, this ache in them and this searching for other things is actually a hunger for God, and they're not even aware that he wants to be with them. So there's that group of people. And then there's the other group who I feel like they do know that there's more. They know full well that what they're walking in is not what he has for them, right? So but maybe they don't know how to get to that more. Like, yeah, that's fantastic, Michelle, that idea of more of God or intimacy with God. That sounds great, and I can even get excited about that, but I don't even know how to get there. Nobody's told me how to get there, what to do. You know, is it something I just sit and wait for? Do I have to do something? Is it a works thing? And so they know that there's more. They don't know how to get to it, okay? But underneath this group, too, there also might be some who are unwilling to a certain extent to do what it takes. They're not willing, you know, and maybe they're not ready yet. And so I'm not at all heaping condemnation on anybody. It's the Holy Spirit that opens our eyes, who draws us, all of that stuff. So please don't hear condemnation in this. But, you know, maybe there's a certain unwillingness to surrender, to yield, a fear. Okay, maybe there's fear stopping them from doing it. You know, and maybe they just need to hear that he's calling. So let me tell you, ladies, he is knocking, okay? He is knocking on your door. No matter which camp you find yourself in, what level you're at, he is knocking and he's calling you. I wrote down a couple verses. For the eyes of the Lord range throughout the earth to strengthen those whose hearts are fully committed to him. And I've said this, and I don't mean to keep drilling this in, but he wants our whole hearts fully committed to him. In Revelations, it says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in to him and eat with him, and he with me." So there's a hearing of his voice. That's what popped off to me. We need to hear his voice. And if all we hear is the world clamoring, we're not going to hear his voice. And so we need to hear him, which signifies we actually need to be listening for his voice. And then when he's knocking, we actually need to open the door. Our response is opening the door. Jesus said in John, "On the last day of the feast, the great day, Jesus stood up and cried, 'If anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water.'" Okay? So thirsting can be a response, or thirsting can be a need. Let him come to me. Okay? So there's a response that needs to happen there. Hello, Sarah. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. So there's kind of a prerequisite there. You're not going to be filled if you're not hungry and thirsty for him. In Hebrews, it talks about how he rewards those who diligently seek him. Okay, so there is something on our part. There has to be a response. It's not enough to just simply hear him calling, "Hi, Jenny." We've got to respond. And of course, he is sovereign, and he could fall on us with his manifest presence at any moment, right? I am not saying that he's beyond that, that it all depends upon us. But the scripture is so clear that we must respond to him. Hear his voice, which means listening, looking for him, to see him. We have to look for him, to thirst and to hunger and to open that door. So, I want you to ask yourselves, do you hear him knocking, this season that you're in your life? Do you hear him knocking? Do you hear him calling you to himself? Do you hear him calling you to a higher place, a deeper place with him? I'd like you just to think about that a second. Do you hear him calling you? Do you long for more of his abiding presence, you know, an awareness of his presence? Do you long for more of that, more intimacy with him? You know, as I've been talking about this, and intimacy with him, and more and deeper and all of that, do you long for that? If you do, in any way, shape, or form, that is him calling you. That's him knocking on the door, calling you to a higher level with him. And if you don't, I don't want you to feel bad about it. I want you to get on your knees and say, "Make me hungry, Lord. Make me thirsty." We can't. It is the Father who draws us. We can't. It's not in and of ourselves. It's grace. And so get down on your knees. So if you're the one who's like, "Yeah, I hear him," then open the blasted door. If you're the one who's like, "Yeah, I don't even hear him. I don't even know if he's calling me. I'm not hungry. I'm not thirsty." Then get on your knees and say, "Lord, make me hungry for you. Do whatever it takes to make me hungry for you." So don't be content. These are just some things that I felt like one-liners that came in my head. Don't be content with simply the sense of an invitation. Like, "Oh, that's cool. God's calling me." Don't be content with that. You have got to respond. And these three words I heard today: doubt, distractions, and steward. Okay. So many people I know, like we were talking this morning, the kids and I were talking about hearing from God. The enemy has so mystified this whole hearing from God thing. Like it's some big thing we have to drum up, and it only happens once in a while, and I don't hear from God, and all of those are lies of the enemy. Those are doubts. Doubts God wants to speak to me, doubt that he does. Those are lies from the enemy. God is always speaking. Jesus is the word of God. He is always speaking. And Jesus said, "My sheep know my voice." So if you're his child, if you're his sheep, you know his voice, okay? So something's obstructing it. Something's convinced you can't hear it, but you can hear his voice. And it might be something here that we dive into in this coming year, because I know so many people struggle with this, that like they're not sure they're hearing from God. We've not been taught, you know. I just think of my, you know, I don't know, last 25 plus years of walking with the Lord, and I don't know how many teachings were really about hearing God's voice and how to practically do that. So doubt. We doubt that we even hear his voice. Okay. We talked about distractions a little bit yesterday. I can't think of the wording. A tolerated obstruction, okay? Obstructions to hearing from God or walking with him or being more intimate with him, these obstructions that we actually tolerate, we just let them be there, okay? So distractions, we talked about Mary and Martha, how she was busy with much distractions, and tolerated obstructions. I like that phrase. Okay, so we got doubts, We've got distractions and then stewarding. And I talked about this a little bit earlier last week about stewarding what he does give us. The verse, his master said to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You are faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." And I have found, like I shared, the more I steward a dream or hearing his voice or getting a scripture, a rhema word in my quiet time, if I just blow that off and go about my day, I kind of feel like, what's the point? Is he going to maybe just stop at some point? Like, you're not listening anyway. But if he gives me something and I steward it, like, hi, Lisa, like last night, you know, I had just kind of given a mental assent to, like, if you were to wake me up at 2 something, then I would know. He woke me up at 2 something. I could smile and go back to bed, or I can get on my knees and turn the light on and say, I'm here. You called. And I'm here. I didn't have a plan. I didn't know what he wanted. I didn't know, should I turn worship music on? Should I open my Bible? I didn't know. I just sat with him. He called me and I want to respond. And so when I say steward what he's given you, that's my exhortation. Whether it's scripture, whether it's, you know, sensing his presence in worship, dreams, visions, prophetic words, whatever it is, don't blow them off. This is Jesus speaking to us and wanting to be with us. So, my daughter was just telling me just this precious time that she had with the Lord last night and how she, you know, was talking to him and she felt like he was saying, you know, to take his hand, and she put her hand out and she almost felt like there was like a weight on her hand. She goes, I don't know, Mom. I'm like, Sarah Grace, steward that, focus on that, thank him for that. Believe that he met you. She could have just blown it off. I encourage her to journal about it, revisit it, thank him for it. These are the things that I mean when I say steward what he's given you. And I really believe the more we steward the little things, the very little things that we learn. I read a book this past year about praying in the Spirit, and it's like it was a tool I had laid down, and I picked that tool back up. And I'm telling you, the more I steward the revelations that he's given me, the more he's giving me. And I feel like that's a principle. You're going to be faithful in a little, he's going to give you much. Okay, so see where there's doubt and repent of that and get rid of it. See what the distractions are. Sit your buns down with him today and say, Lord, what are the distractions in my life? What is keeping me from a fuller relationship with you, deeper intimacy? What are these obstructions that I just tolerate in my life? Pray that your eyes would be open. As a matter of fact, we're going to pray after this. And then steward well what he gives you, okay? So I know this today was supposed to be reframe, and like I said, I just chose it because it's the best RE word to go with the rest of them. But I want it to be a respond. I want today to be a respond to this invitation. we have a new year ahead of us. He has been incredibly faithful this past year. For even those of you who have gone through hell and back twice in the last year, he has still been faithful. Hello, Rose. Good morning. We have a good, good Father, and he's been faithful, and he will be faithful. He doesn't change. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So his faithfulness of last year is going to carry into this year. So we have a hope and a future and good in front of us. So let's respond with a whole heart, a heart yielding to him, okay? So I'm going to pray for us that we would yield our hearts, that we would hear his voice clearly, and that we would respond, okay? Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. You're so good. You love us so much, Lord. You are calling us, Lord, calling us to deeper walk with you, Lord. Intimacy with you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, I ask that you would expose and remove all doubt, doubt that we hear your voice. Fear, fear we're going to miss you somehow. I pray by the power of the Holy Spirit that you just shine your light on that right now, even now as we're praying, Lord. Eyes to be opened. Expose the lies of the enemy. And I also pray, Lord, that you would show us the distractions, the little foxes, the things that we tolerate. Lord, even the things we're unwilling to lay down. The little idols in our lives that we don't even see as idols, Lord, I pray that you would reveal them and give us a heart to lay them down. I pray for each woman listening to this video, Lord, that you would just tell them right now, as they quiet their hearts before you, what distractions, what's keeping them from you? Something practical might be something with social media, might be, I don't know, something you're reading, might be fear. Holy Spirit, speak to their hearts, let them hear your voice. Father, give us grace to steward what you've given us. Help us to see that even if the only thing we can think of that you've given us is mercy, that we would steward even that mercy well. But we would steward your word, times of worship with you, Lord, dreams, visions, prophetic words, however you choose, Lord, to interact with us. That we wouldn't take those for granted, but that we would steward them well. That we would show our hungry heart for more. That we would say, oh, thank you, Papa, thank you, more. Give me more, I want more of you. Lord, as they take time to be with you today, I ask for you to just give them a vision for their new year, for this next season. Name their season for them, Lord, give them a word. Prophesy over their year, Jesus. Speak right to their hearts. Make it clear. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, ladies, that's all I'll ramble on today. I'm assuming, because I haven't seen any comments, I can see who's on, but nobody's commented. And that's fine. Oh, there's Gail. Thank you, Gail. Oh, now they're all coming in. Oh, I hope I didn't miss them. That's strange. Okay. Yeah, Gail, what did you say there? Yeah, how to get there. No conscious hunger at the moment. Lord Jesus, right now, I pray that you overwhelm Gail with just a hunger and thirst for you, Lord. If there's anything she needs to remove out of her life, Lord, that would cause her to hunger, Lord, I pray that you show her right now. Yes, Lord, hunger is a natural state of your children, I believe. Lord, allow her, allow all of us to get hungry for you, Jesus. Only you can do it, Lord. Only you can do it. Reveal yourself in such a beautiful, powerful way that we can't help but want more of you. Yeah, he's so good, ladies. He's so good. All right, I'm going to go. I just asked my 21-year-old if he would get his guitar out and worship with me, so I'm going to do that while my poor husband is trying to fix the bathroom sink that I decided to clean out last week. Anyway, just take some time to be with him today, okay? Respond to the invitation. It's not going to work if you don't open the door when someone knocks, you open the door. So open the door today to Jesus. Spend some time with him and hear what he has to speak over your year. And we will share tomorrow. So excited. All right, have a fantastic day.